Good morning, everyone. I'm Shraddha. Let's talk about today's market outlook. Today, SGX Nifty is giving us a positive indication as SGX Nifty is at 15,825 levels, lower 11 points. Nasdaq had shown a good movement yesterday, so today you will be able to see positive impact on Asian markets. So in this case, let's see what should be your strategy for Nifty and Bank Nifty. Let's talk about Nifty and Bank Nifty outlook. Nifty finds support around 15,650, while 15,850 will act as resistance. Talking about Bank Nifty, then Bank Nifty finds support around 34,500, while 35,400 will act as resistance. For intraday traders, in cash intraday, you can buy CDSL between 995 to 998 rupees. Stop loss you can keep at 985 rupees. Target you can keep at 1005 rupees. For derivative future call intraday, you can buy Godrej CP future at 924 rupees. Stop loss you can place at 920 rupees. Target you can keep at 929. For derivative option call intraday, you can buy Bajaj Finance 6200 CE at 190 rupees, stop loss at 165 rupees and target at 215 rupees. On 14 June, we had given you intraday calls for Alkem in cash intraday and Zindal Steel future in derivative future intraday. So let me tell you, the target have been achieved for both the calls. So congratulations to all of you. Let's talk about stock and news. So Vatek Vabag, Porinjo Veliath owned Equity Intelligence India Private Limited and EQ India Fund sold over 7.64 lakhs equity shares or 1.23% stake in Vatek Vabag via open market transaction on June 10, reducing shareholding to 0.64% from 1.87% earlier. Retail and wholesale inflation touch record high. Talking about CPI, then Consumer Price Index, India's retail inflation rose to 6.3% in May 2021. This has been considered as the highest in almost 6 months. CPI has crossed RBI's targeted band of 2-6%. Inflation rate in April was at 4.23%. Food inflation shot up to 5% from 2% in April. WPI, that is Wholesale Price Index, a measure for wholesale inflation, rose to a record high of 12.94% in May 2021 from the same month last year. WPI in April was at 10.49%. This is mainly due to rising crude oil prices. Another reason is the low base effect, as WPI in May 2020 was at -3.37%. Let's discuss about international markets. So firstly, US markets. US markets closed mixed with Dow Jones, recovering from intraday fall of over 260 points to close lower by 80 points, while Nasdaq closes in the green third day running as lower yields cease buying in technology or digital stocks. US 10-year trades at 1.49% even as crude oil prices hit 16 months high. Asian markets were trading in the green, led by the Japanese Nikkei, which was up over 250 points in early trade. Metals and technology stocks led the gainers, while banks saw profit booking in most Asian markets. Chinese data on manufacturing beat estimates, however, stocks have been range bound with consolidation in most markets, awaiting the Federal Reserve action on Wednesday. That's it for morning outlook. Post market hours, we will meet again with closing updates. So don't miss to join us at 5:30 PM today. And also do not forget to subscribe our 5 Paise channel. Stay tuned. Bye.